Hey everyone, Zian over here from Nintendo Life, and I am so absolutely just humbled and thrilled to be able to share with you that we got the exclusive look at a brand new game coming to the Nintendo Switch called Knockout City.
Wait, it got revealed in the Direct an hour ago?
Okay, so maybe we didn't get that kind of exclusive inside look, but we did get to go hands-on with the game for 2 whole hours. Granted, it was the PC version, not the Switch version, but I got to play a ton of matches with Snowbike Mike from Kinda Funny Games. He is so nice and so cool. I had a great time, and I'm gonna tell you all about it. Knockout City is a third-person multiplayer action dodgeball game that almost feels like a hybrid of ARMS and Splatoon, but instead of using guns and throwing punches, you're throwing dodgeballs as your weapon. On the surface, the game is very simple. You run around a map, you pick up dodgeballs, you chuck them at enemies, you can catch dodgeballs, you can throw them back, you dodge and weave. It's very, very simple on paper. You can toss a dodgeball at an opponent in tons of different ways. You can throw it straight on, you can throw a special hook shot, you can lob it in from up above like a grenade. And the best part is you don't need to be super precise with your aiming either, as the game actually locks onto your opponents, and it'll help you target the enemy that way. And that doesn't mean the game is always on this sort of easy mode. There's still tons of other stuff to focus about. It just takes the aiming sort of off your shoulders. And if a ball comes flying at you, which it will, you can either dash forward and deflect it, or if your timing is quick enough, you can catch it and lob it back at your enemy. And with the fact that you have to be precise with all of this, timing plays a huge part in the game. When a ball comes flying at you, you'll see your screen get a little red, and you'll actually be able to hear the wind buzz as the ball comes flying at you. And then if you do catch it, you can throw it right back at your opponent. Or you can fake them out and make them think that you're going to throw it, which then gives you an opening to actually toss the ball at them, if they decide to try and catch it when you fake them out. This catch mechanic can lead to a lot of insane back and forths as you're trying to catch the ball and try and play mind games with your opponents as you're dodging and weaving and rushing all around the maps, especially if more people start coming into the area and are also starting to get into the fray with you. It's super chaotic and crazy, but somehow the developers managed to make it still all seem very seamless and stable. A lot of this stuff goes right over my head, so apologies if I'm incorrect about any of this, but Valeyan basically built their own engine to host the networking side of the game. Things like rollback and netcode, I don't really understand and I didn't have a ton of time to dig into it, but those are all things that they considered when developing this game. But throwing dodgeballs, catching them, and getting the timing down right is much different than like in an FPS or a third-person shooter. And while I was playing the game, I didn't notice one time any significant lag or it ever feeling like that I was cheated by the game. I always felt that my own skill was either carrying me or hindering me in my experiences. And landing a shot is extremely satisfying too. Not to pull up any traumatic memories for anybody, but when you actually land a shot with the dodgeball, it makes that, there's that one sound that's just super satisfying. You know, when you actually hit someone with a dodgeball, that's in the game. And you kind of get some of that similar feeling when you actually land a shot. Now, each match will also have a special ball that can be picked up alongside your standard dodgeball. There's a moon ball, which affects gravity for the person wielding it and the person that gets hit. There's a bomb ball, which will blow up after a set amount of time. And there's also a cage ball, which will actually capture someone and put them in a ball, which then you could pick up and toss at your opponent, or you can take them and throw them off a ledge and actually get a KO that way. And it's super painful when it happens. We were able to go hands-on with 3 different multiplayer maps. The first of which was Team KO, a 3v3 race to get the most knockouts in a set amount of time. There's also Diamond Dash, another 3v3 mode which has you KOing opponents and stealing their diamonds. But then you also have Ball Up Brawl, which is a 4v4 multiplayer mode that uses a unique mechanic that we haven't really gotten to talk about yet. In Knockout City, you can actually crouch down into a ball, and your opponent can pick you up and then throw you. And in this Ball Up Brawl mode, there are no dodgeballs, so you're forced to use each other as ammunition. It's pretty unique, as you actually have to be careful not to throw each other off the map. And if an opponent actually catches a ball or a person that you throw at them, then they can throw them back at you, still just like a normal dodgeball. There's also a special move where if you pick somebody up, you can kind of chuck them up in the air, kind of like in Splatoon, where you'll see the Inklings kind of teleport across the map. This character that gets thrown up can kind of like dive bomb onto the map and can destroy everything within a certain vicinity. I didn't catch how often you can actually use that, but it's pretty devastating when it works. You can kill all three or four people in one go. I also absolutely loved the art style. It oozes this sort of like video game charm that you'd find in like something like Jet Set Radio, which actually came up in the developer preview that I had with the games. There's also a ton of different character customization options. And the cool thing is that there aren't any classes in the game either, so every character is going to play the same regardless of how they look. So your skill as a player is really going to come into play with how well you perform in the game. Which also means there's no pay-to-win options. There's no loot boxes either. You can buy new skins with real-world money, but you can also pay for them with in-game currency. Now, I'm not sure how easily that currency is going to be dished out into the game, but the developers say that they're going to be fairly generous with it. There are going to be new seasons that happen. I believe they are going to last 9 weeks long, they said, and they'll be bringing over new ball types, new game modes, new maps, and other additional features to the game. Now, like I said, we didn't get to go hands-on with the Switch version. We just played specifically on the PC version, which is all of the gameplay that I'm going to be showing off in this video is from the PC build. But graphically, it doesn't seem like this is anything that the Switch can't handle. It is a very good looking game on PC, but I don't think the Switch is going to be losing out a ton graphically. Fingers crossed though. Sadly, we did find out that there will be no motion, no gyro controls at all for the Switch version. I think that's sort of a missed opportunity there, but maybe they'll add that at a later date. And if you were looking to play this offline or thought that you could play some local multiplayer with some friends, sadly there are no offline modes either. Now potentially they could add something like that at a future date, sort of like what Splatoon did with some of its story DLC campaigns for Splatoon 2, but we'll see. It seems like online multiplayer is their focus. Now one of my favorite parts about the game is that it is a $20 purchase, once and done. Any additional content, any other maps, anything like that that get added to the game, you'll all be able to get those for free with that purchase of the base game. Kind of like in Overwatch, something like that. Of course, any cosmetics that you want, you'll still have to buy those with in-game currency or real-world money. Any new balls, anything like that, that will all be added to the game for you, the player who purchased the game for free. And the cool thing is that when the game launches, there's actually going to be a trial period, which we're not sure how long this lasts, but everybody is going to be able to play the game on Switch, Xbox One, PS4, whatever system, PS5, Xbox Series X, for free. For a limited amount of time, you're gonna have full access to the game, which sounds pretty crazy, but I suppose if people like it enough, then realistically they'll buy the game and they'll play it more. Kind of like a Fall Guys scenario on PlayStation Plus, I guess. I don't know. I don't know how they make money off that. It's sweet. And I had a ton of fun with the game. You know, if I had the right group, I would definitely play this more often. But I should also just play Splatoon 2 more often, and I don't do that. But regardless, I had a ton of fun with Knockout City. I can't wait to see it on Switch. But of course, I'm curious to hear what you think of this new game. Do you enjoy its weird kind of futuristic graffiti art style? I'm digging it a lot, but let us know what you think. And as always, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more content like this, then why don't you go ahead and catch that curveball that the subscribe button tossed at you, and then toss it right back. And then ring that notification bell to be notified whenever we release new videos. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm Xian from Nintendo Life. Stay safe out there, and we will see you next time.